Nylander for Marner. Slot to Morris. Domi got a stick on that. It'll come to Matthews. Time running down. Nylander can't get it through. It'll be sent ahead. And Brooklyn Greg is going to put the finishing touches on an Ottawa win. And series win. And Morgan Rielly takes exception to that. And the Battle of Ontario will boil over here.
A reaction you don't usually see from Morgan Rielly, but he's all over it. It's been a good game and a hard-fought third period, and I understand the response. For Greg, you don't need to be showing up like that, but the reaction, not a good one, and now they're still going. As Rielly was separated and sent in, they got another battle going on as Tavares is in the middle of it as well.
Domi in the middle of it. Pinto and Matthews with words, but most of the guys that aren't involved in the rough stuff for the Leafs are out there. And
now it's just a good defensive play here as Greg gets the block. The game's over, you know, the time is ticking away. You don't need that, but you don't need this for Rielly too, and you got to be careful. You don't take more than just a 2-minute penalty. You got to have a better look at how bad it was afterwards. As Rielly came flying in, and then Pinto trying to... Oh yeah, there's the cross check. The battle continues in the stands, yeah. And I don't think that play for Greg was needed at all, but
he get the puck. Very good chance. Kucherov, his shot was blocked, and Pajot has the puck, and he's racing off to an empty net. That is going to be a penalty on the play, or was going to be. Pajot doesn't like the fact that he got hooked and got a whack from Kucherov, and this is what happens as the Islanders take the 5-3 lead with the empty net goal. Settling a few scores.
It was the hack at the end, the frustration there with the hook. The goal was going to be good no matter. But the extra hack is what Pajot took exception to. And they're still, John, as they go out of the pile and into the middle. They've been going at it all night long.
The 25th blocked shot of the night for the New York Islanders turns into the turnover that sprung Pajot. Now, boys. Hey boys, you've got to live in the same hotel together. Don't be talking to each other like that.
Well, what a third period for Barry Trotz and his team to give up the lead by two and then to somehow be able to come back. Here's the battle that ensued after a couple of hooks. This is where the arm went up, so that's going to be a goal. It's the extra slash at the end that Pajot has had enough, and he came back at him hard. We saw in the first period on, these two have been slated up against each other, and you know, an opportunity for Tampa tonight to take a resounding 3-0 lead. Instead, the fight continued in the Islanders, and they found a way to, despite giving up the lead, to bring it back and make this a series again. Look at the looks on the Islanders bench, a little different.
Puck back, and Pettersson, who already has 4 points tonight. There's point number 5, and his second goal of the night for Elias Pettersson.
And Konechny gave him a little shot after the goal, and you can see J.T. Miller is following Konechny, and if John Tortorella is smart, he's not going to put him out there for the last 40 seconds. Frustration for Konechny and the Flyers. This will be 4 in a row. And look at that shot. There's another one right through. There's 2 Flyers there, and pull it back, give yourself an angle, and thank you. And there's Konechny giving him the little shoulder-to-shoulder hit. And that's when you only play twice a year.
Yeah.
October, and now you don't play them again till next year. You can do that.
Yeah.
If you played them next week, guess what would happen?
Of course.
He's going to add to the total. The puck and Hagel into the net. That's 2 hat tricks tonight.
And then the Hawks unhappy with the ensuing sequence.
Well, P.K. Subban takes a penalty, tripping on Hankel as he's going to the empty net, and Kirby Dach didn't like it. Went right after P.K. in the corner, and the ensuing brawl happened. So great job by Hankel to get the goal, and tensions rise here at the United Center. About Hagel wheeling and dealing to the net there, but it's a slash and then a trip by P.K. Subban. So not just one, but two plays there. And
oh,
now
we're
it's
not done.
Fisticuffs. Tangled up with their pack.
It's Hagel himself. Why wouldn't he be upset? I mean, the game is pretty much over. It's a really cheap play by P.K. Subban.
Dangerous play.
And a dangerous one. I mean, thank heavens those nets are more easily separated from their stanchion. Back in the day, that would have been a real problem. But there's Hagel, the second hat trick of the night for the Blackhawks. 88-38 with six goals between them.
Oh, I love to see it, too, the reaction from the bench. He's revving up the crowd with the hand, and then everybody on the bench, Mackenzie Entwistle, patting him on the helmet, congratulating him on the fight. So you look back at it now and you can see Hagel looking at PK like, what are you doing? You know, cheap shot. PK frustrated obviously with the loss and starts the fight back and forth. Nice job by Hagel defending himself in what was, like you said, Pat, just a dangerous play at the end of the game. So
moves it. Heischer regains control. He got popped down from behind by Ekblad. A steal and a goal for New Jersey as Thomas Tatar makes it 4-2.
Oh, credit the goaltender, Mackenzie Blackwood. I mean, what a contest. As we got a frustrated scrum going on right after this one. And Tatar was the one that scored the goal in the empty net after Quinn Hughes,
Oh, Kachuk's got Heischer.
Oh, here we go.
Kachuk saw an opportunity to go after Nico Heischer. And the officials have done all they can to try and break him apart.
Yeah, but Heischer's got to be prepared for this here. Once he turned his back, Kachuk went right back at him. Both linesmen there have got their hands full.
This is stemming back from their meeting on Saturday when Nico Heischer injured Alexander Barkov in a face-off in the first period. And Kachuk, with the game seemingly out of reach, saw an opportunity and took it.
Well, Jack Hughes had fired the puck. It rolled wide. The Devils stay with it. Heischer on that ice late in the game. But here's the saves that have taken place. Here's the one by Reinhardt. This was a bullet. I mean, and he went high to the glove side, an area that they haven't touched very often in this game. And then this is the play by Montour, Jennifer, just keeping this puck. And watch his skate blade right there.
Oh, not necessarily your most conventional play, but made it happen. This is the one where Kachuk just fired it wide.
He had more time there than he thought, and he pushed it wide.
This is the one 2-on-0, though. 2-on-0, and they just couldn't quite settle the puck to get the chance that they wanted to. And this is one a little too casual in your zone, right? You know the Devils are coming in, and Tatar finishes that one off to get the insurance that they needed for this one.
That brings the Devils to 22-9-2 and snapped a four-game losing streak. That goaltender deserves a lot of credit. Nico Heischer came into this game knowing he was going to be a target, knowing that after that play by Sasha Barkov, and even at the very end, you still got to the clock is still going, or it stopped because of that, but the game's still going. You got to know that something might be coming your way. And it looked like he came away from this unscathed. He's right here to my right. He doesn't have his helmet on right now, but just breathing heavily because of that's just a tough grind right there. And then you're trying to find your balance because you're going to be toppled over. You don't want to blow a wheel going down like that. But he played hard all game from the opening faceoff when that line started. Jennifer, yeah. Tatar, Heischer, and Zetterlund started the game, and he was hit and he went at him.